She got me. Yeah, girl. Still. She really got me going. She got me so I don't know what I'm doing.
Oh, yeah.
What's up, YouTube?
Hello. It's your boy.
Eric. And that guy over there with the face.
Travis, don't tell people I have a face. That's personal.
I'm sorry.
They didn't know.
Beep that out.
There you go. Yeah. No, we
so now we'll say with the beep.
we can't beep in the first minute. It's not allowed.
And this is Bookend Gaming. Oh, hello. Yeah. We're back with Lily.
Beep this whole intro out.
Her sister.
Akira.
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 Battle Angel.
Yeah. That's Alita.
I know.
There's an anime called Akira, and it's like super popular, and I've never seen it, and everyone's gonna lynch me now.
Oh no! I haven't seen it, and I am the anime watcher.
I am the one who animates.
Sounds like it's pretty busy for you then.
At least I'm not cooking your meals after school anymore.
As they talk, I slowly realize they're speaking British.
Wait a second.
I'm entirely unable to gauge Lily's emotions through her eyes, as I would for any other person. It becomes slightly unsettling as I subconsciously focus on that fact. And
I guess I'll just look somewhere else.
Whoa, so cold. Weren't you just cooking for yourself anyway? I only ever got leftovers.
That's not the point. Are you managing to feed yourself, at least?
I can cook without blowing myself up, you know. Or I can order out. Mostly.
That's...
Haha, it's fine, it's fine.
how droll.
You.
Haha.
I had Hanako over the other day and scared the shit out of her.
You're having a laugh.
I needed to learn sometime anyway.
Lily?
Everyone present is momentarily distracted by Yuko. Places a cup of tea on the table for Lily.
Cockblock.
Taking the moment to glance at her watch, Akira levers herself off her seat and gives me a quick nod.
She's all yours, kid.
Well, I better be off. It was nice talking to you, Lily.
Akira, do you have to...
Lily looks genuinely mournful at her sister suddenly leaving. It does seem like she might have the wrong idea.
Please don't leave me with him.
We have shopped with her, so it's not completely weird.
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry, I need to get back to work. They'll be on my neck again if I don't make it back quickly.
So informal. Ugh, Akira's trim and tidy appearance would give anyone the wrong impression of her.
Bye, Akira.
She looks like a Final Fantasy character.
She does. A male Final Fantasy character.
Come on, don't look so down. I'll be around again. See yas.
With that, she waltzes out of the Shanghai with her hand held high.
Later.
Smell you later.
Lily still looks pretty depressed, so I try to make some small talk in an effort to take her mind off it. She seems nice.
She's not. We used to live together. But now that I live at school, we hardly ever see each other.
Despite Lily having been quite affable, I still don't really know much about her. Or the meaning of affable. In hindsight.
Sight,
It's surprising just how much she's extracted from me, really. Just do it every time. You used to live together. Was it somewhere around here?
It was pretty far south, so the trip into Yamaku was fairly long. With her working... I see where you're going with that. With her working hours getting longer and Yamaku being so far away, there was little choice in the end but to move into the dormitories.
Well, that explains the chatter about cooking. Evidently regaining her composure, she livens back up, at least in part.
I take it you're better rested now. It's just weird that you sat down and, like, they just talked to each other and you just sat silently the entire time.
Right. Sorry?
You sound less exhausted than you did when you first came in.
To be able to pick out my breathing like that, she must have pretty good ears.
Oh god, now I'm thinking about my breathing. I can't stop!
Is everyone hearing it? Oh god. Yeah, and walking where's, all over town.
Where's the comfortable place to put my tongue in my mouth?
No, don't make me think things like that. despite only planning on taking a short walk down here. Reminded of my thirst from the walk, I lean forward to take a sip. I am one thirsty bitch.
Yeah, coffee, that's real thirst quenching.
Without further ado, Lily starts on her cup of strong smelling tea. It's got vodka in it. I guess I'd better get back to Yamaku. There's only so long I can stall studying for, and I want to get a good night's sleep before the festival. Standing from my seat, I take the coffee-stained cup from the table. Ew.
You're leaving?
Yep. you going to head back as well? It's getting kind of late.
I don't know where I am.
For a moment, she pauses before lifting her face over her teacup as if she was looking at me. You mean we're not in the school cafeteria?
Yuko, could we have one more coffee, please?
Okay, I'll bring it right away.
That's not subtle. What?
She's trying to keep you around.
She gives a short giggle at my frank assessment of her maneuver. It's surprisingly childish and carefree, given her otherwise collected appearance.
She's already putting the moves on you.
Hew-hew. In the end, though, I have little reason to refuse. To be honest, I can hardly say no, all things considered.
It's a girl, man.
Giving a manufactured sigh, I take a seat opposite her. Weren't you sitting next to her? Why give that seat up?
No, I think they were... I don't think you were sitting next, were you?
I think so.
I thought maybe you were like on the end of the table and they were on the two sides. One That's how I pictured
there?
It, at least.
Oh, kind of like they sat with Misha and Shizune.
Yeah.
I was on the edge.
I'd say that it's more that I was wondering.
I see she's in question mode again. She seems to be... She does seem to be unusually interested in me, or at least curious.
What does that dick do? Do you have any siblings? I mean...
Not exactly an unexpected tangent. No, only child. To be honest, the idea of having someone that close makes me a bit envious.
Interesting.
I raise an eyebrow, which of course goes unseen. The short silence communicates the question well enough. My dad's Batman, though, so that's pretty cool.
No grandparents, though. Kind of sucks.
It's just that others have said the same thing before. It's a difficult subject to try and think about objectively, given that I've always had someone like that.
I can mostly understand what Lily means, given that it would be hard to place oneself outside of a situation they've been in all their life. She and her sister must have a pretty close relationship. How about how close?
That's hot.
Taking pains to interrupt us as little
and
as
illegal.
Possible. Yuko dutifully comes over and places a cup on the table. Lily thanks her as I sit back, taking in this vexing girl in front of me. Don't look at her boobs. Oh, wait. Despite always
want.
Seeming to be on her guard and in control of herself, when talking to others, she has an almost childlike curiosity about other people. That said, those rare moments she seems to slightly lower her guard are the most insightful into how she thinks. Reaching forward for my drink, I realize something I probably should have noticed earlier. I think I'm starting to become kind of curious about her.
Oh, no.
Already, man? God, what? It's episode 2. Calm your dick. Despite making a good pace, it's already nightfall by the time I reach the large iron gates in front of the school.
God, why don't you just bang it out in the first act?
Right? He'll be all over Lily.
No wonder this is the best route.
He was all over Lily when he was with Hanako.
That's true.
While it's nice to have plenty of time to wander around by virtue of living right next to the school, I can't help but get the feeling that very few students actually take the opportunity. Compared to the number of students I see milling around on campus during free time, it's startlingly rare to see anyone around town. Given the large number of accommodations and facilities that the school offers, like a pool, many of them might simply not see any point in venturing outside, let alone people such as Hanako and Kenji.
Yeah, those losers never go anywhere.
It makes me wonder if students like Shizune, Misha, and Lily are the exceptions for this school, rather than the norm.
Oh, I'm in with the cool kids.
Yeah, the only kids that we get to see. Well, that's not true. There's a couple more.
Yeah, I mean, we see all those shadow creatures all the time.
Right, and those juniors or whatever, AOE, and I can't remember the other girl's
name.
As I wander back to my dorm room, oh no, I continue to compare my old school with Yamaku. As I do so, I begin to be surprised that I managed to get even this used to everything that's happened to me. And I die right in the hallway.
And...
Goodbye, cruel world.
That was a really slow fade.
Yeah, it was. It took me a while to go to sleep. Please don't be Kenji. Please don't be Kenji.
It's Kenji!
The next day, I wake up feeling a little lightheaded. It's almost noon already. Damn!
Jeez.
Sleeping late is fine, since it's Sunday and there are no classes. Not just a Sunday, though, but Super Bowl Sunday! The festival as well. From my window, I can already see some people at the soba booth slinging noodles onto plates for people with a craving for low-quality food. This we may have seen.
Let's see. But we're going to be hanging around Lily more.
Yeah, here we go.
Okay.
Please don't say anything new. Please don't say anything new.
Go into the thing.
That blonde bitch! All right, we're good.
Go into the thing. She is working at the booth.
Yeah.
Gonna help her.
Gonna have some soup? No, we're not, I guess. Oh, here we go. Right. I know what I'll do. Even if it's just one person, I'll make the festival more enjoyable for her.
Who?
I don't know. We should probably...
No, we know who. Come on.
As I place the bowl on the counter, I call out to Lily. No need to yell. I'm right here.
Hasao. You brought it back.
Yeah, here. Toss it to her.
Now wash it.
I slide it into her hands, and she takes it over to someone who is apparently on cleaning duty. Considering that I didn't see them here before...
See?
It's probably a penalty for their tardiness. Hey, Lily? She perks up and returns to the counter as she hears my voice again, realizing that I'm still here. Want to go see some more of the festival?
Oh, no. You said that one out loud.
She puffs her cheeks disapprovingly. It looks kind of cute and in complete contradiction to her usually uncute, ugly, reserved nature. It takes a few seconds for me to get what she's taking issue with. Whoops.
Oh, she caught that one.
I didn't mean to.
I meant feel. You want to feel the festival.
Lily giggles at me, exposing her teasing for what it is. There's plenty of things we can do with our hands instead.
You're still not used to the school, are you?
She got me. Yeah, girl.
Still.
She really got me going. She got me so I don't know what I'm doing.
Oh, yeah. I kind of need to stay with our stall. It's taken until just now to even get everything unpacked.
I guess her reluctance shouldn't overly surprise me, considering how much work she's put into this. Everything seems to be running fine now, though. Besides, you've got extra help on hand anyway. Just leave it to them. A boy in the middle of cooking some soba noodles turns towards us, grinning.
Me! Go on, Lils! You've earned yourself a break! We can hold down the fort for now!
What a cool guy. Best wingman ever. If you say it's okay, then I suppose.
Oh god, I spilled everything!
He's like, we got this handle, and he's currently standing over a trash can trying to cook things. But if you need any help.
Then we'll call you! Go on, we'll be fine!
Lily finally gives up her resistance as he waves a spatula at her. She feels her way around the back of the stall and picks up her cane on the way.
She actually didn't want to go. She was just using that as an excuse, and that guy screwed her out of her excuse.
We got it! Don't worry!
Are you sure?
No, I can stay.
I guess the first thing we should do is look for Hanako. Lily seems kind of worried about her, and I doubt she'd be the kind of person to enjoy milling around in crowds like this all alone. So I guess we should search for Hanako. Where to first?
My bedroom.
She's always in my bedroom.
Yeah. We'll have to look under the covers.
She's tied there right now. Both of us go quiet for a moment to think. Maybe she's in her dorm room, hopefully?
I doubt it. She doesn't keep too many things in there. Just a bunch of stupid dolls. So she'd have nothing to do.
Her monochromatic room.
Yeah. Ah, the library?
I remember, she does like books. As good a place as any to search for an avid reader, I suppose. The library it is. We'll check there then, first then. Aside from the muffled sounds of the crowd seeping in from outside, the inside of the school seems almost deserted. In order to make sure everyone had enough room, I guess all the events were organized to be held outside on school grounds. They're definitely quite large by any other school standards.
It's nice and quiet in here, isn't it?
Yeah, much nicer than the hustle and bustle outside. We take our time and slowly walk through the first floor of the school, eventually reaching the stairs to the second floor, because that's how floors work.
You have to tell her, we've made it to the second floor.
I can't help but notice how Lily anticipates every door and obstacle, her cane remaining still and her hand skating along the hallway railings. You really know the school well, don't you? She smiles and nods straight ahead.
I've been here for a few years now, so I know where everything is. The dorms still trip me up, though, sometimes. I haven't been there as long, and they're not as well laid out as the main building.
They were reorganized. That just must be like a nightmare for blind people.
Oh, yeah, if someone moves, it's like a table.
Like, stores rearrange crap all the time. Yeah. That's gotta
be a pain.
Well,
I mean, that's
what
the cane's for. I guess stores, you can't really hit all the food with
the
cane.
Like, I'm not even in the right section, yeah. Damn it.
If I'm remembering right, they used to be unused buildings before being renovated and used as dormitories.
Dormitories, you say? Yeah, that explains why the male and female dorms looked different from the outside and why their rooms seemed kind of unusual for sleeping quarters. I'd assumed she had been living in the dormitories since she began attending the school, but now I'm reminded of what she said yesterday. That's right. You mentioned that before.
I listen.
I'd assume that most of the students here lived in the dormitories once they enrolled. A lot of them seem to, in any case.
Alright. That's an episode.
Yeah!
Let's find Hanako and ignore her. Completely.
Aw, man.
I mean, we ignored her plenty when Lily was around and Hanako's route.
Right.
I can't imagine it'll be much better in this one.
Are we gonna get more PJ fun?
Oh, yeah. I don't know. Like, Hanako's birthday was a whole big deal, but I don't even know if it'll be a thing. What I'm wondering is if Lily's going to leave town.
Right.
Because she'd
probably go with her, wouldn't
Hanako...
Or
I don't know.
Really going to hang out
Didn't
with
she go for a funeral or something? It was like her uncle's funeral or
so.
Surgery or something. It's been
remember.
A while.
Yes.
Someone will tell us. Don't worry.